Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So I've been having some surge protection or surge problems at my house due to just lightning strikes and storms, especially down here in Florida. I've had some routers, my pool controls, and some other devices go out on me due to surge. So today I'm gonna be installing a full house surge protector on my main service entry right here below my meter. There's actually a main disconnect and breaker right here in the customer accessible panel that we're going to be getting into today. We're going to be installing this new surge protector, so stay tuned. Today I'm gonna be using these Eaton surge protectors right here. I got these as a two pack from Home Depot. I'll have the links down in the description if you guys need these, but they shipped them to me free of charge with everything. And it was actually $10 more to get this kit than it was to get this single whole house surge protector. It was like $10 more to get the data cable one. So I went ahead and just got the two pack instead of ordering the one on Amazon, which is just this one for $150. I think this whole set was $160 or $161. So the main thing I got it for was this, which is 108,000 amps or 108K amps. Which is what they're rated for, and this is good enough for the whole house. In addition, we have this one over here, which is just for the cable line. So it's got a two inputs and two outputs for two cable lines coming into the house. Since I only have one, I'm only be using one side of it. As for what comes in the box, it's pretty basic what it comes with. It basically just comes with four screws for this, which we won't even use for our install because we're just gonna use a knockout and the lock nut right here. The only thing about using the knockout method, especially on my panel, is the one that has a half inch hole is a little bit too close to the wall, and I don't think I have the clearances to get it onto there because I gotta use the next one up, which is a 3/4 inch. So in order to do that, I'm gonna have to plug it with one of these things right here that adapts from a larger conduit or knockout to a half inch. And the reason why I got the 1 inch, it has better coverage. I do have a 1/2 inch to 3/4 inch ones, but I don't think it's going to cover up the hole as well, so I got the little bit bigger ones. In addition, you're going to need some weather tight O-rings, so I just had a few of these O-rings right here that fit perfectly that I'm going to be using right here. For the wiring, it's pretty simple. It's going to have the red and black, which is going to connect to the two sides of your 50 amp breaker. It has a neutral and then it has a ground. For my case, I'll show you in a minute on the bus bar. Since we're putting this on the service entry into the house, that panel actually shares the neutral and the ground is shared. Any other sub panel in your house does not share it. So if you have a sub panel that's away from the main disconnect or the main service coming to the house, you have to make sure this is on the neutral bus and that this is on the ground bus, because those both go back to the main service entry, and it's important that you separate them if you're anywhere else other than the service entry. So like I said, we're gonna need a 50 amp breaker. I'll show you in a minute why I have to repurpose one of the 50 amps that's already in my panel, just because of space limitations. And before anybody mentions anything about double tapping or whatever, these wires on here, they're not designed for current carrying, so double tapping is not a big issue. This thing is really just designed to sense any kind of transient activity in the line. If it sees some huge spike in voltage or amperage, it's gonna try to carry all that down to the ground, which is controlling the surge and protecting the rest of your equipment. These things have a green light that indicate when they're working right, so you gotta make sure that you check on these periodically just to make sure the lights are on and that you're actively being protected. They're basically one-time use, so once it takes a surge and the lights go out, that means it's done its job and you gotta replace this thing. So over here, you'll see the data line or the cable line surge protector, and it looks pretty much like the other one, just a little bit smaller. And with these Eaton ones, they're designed to kind of piggyback off each other. So right here has a little ground bus, and then right here has a ground bus too, and they slide into each other. That way you could attach multiple surge protectors in a row and just have one single ground. But for this particular one, we're not gonna be tapping it or piggybacking off of there. We're gonna be doing this as a standalone in the cable entry. So on the back side of here, you'll see there's a little gold bolt in the middle, and it comes with this extra bar right here. You actually have to unscrew that, add this onto there, and then basically extend this thing above the top of that thing once you mount it. Then you're gonna have to attach this ground wire right here onto that, and then ground this to your nearest ground that's going to actual ground. So the customer accessible panel is right here. So all you do is just lift this up, kind of push this thing back right here. So that way you can drop the panel a little and it swings open. So right here in my panel, I've got my stove on here, my air handler right here. I've got the irrigation 20 amp service, other outlet down here, 20 amp service. And then I've got my pool pump on here on the 30 amp. So right now I don't really have any room in here. Like I said earlier when I was showing you this, I'm gonna double tap my air handler 50 amp right here because this new surge protector requires 50 amps. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna remove this panel right here using these three bolts just to access what's behind here. If you guys aren't comfortable doing this yourself or working in a panel like this, I really suggest hiring a professional. At minimum, you guys should turn off the power right, which is the main power into the house. I work on this stuff all the time, so I'm gonna try to be very careful around this, but we'll just go ahead and open it with it hot. So right now, what I'm gonna use, I'm gonna knock out these knockouts here, right here at the bottom. There's that small quarter inch knockout that's here, but there's not much room against the wall, especially how big that thing is. So I'm gonna knock out the half inch right here. So you just use a screwdriver and hammer, try to avoid touching these two main lugs right here because those are energized right now. And you can go ahead and just pull these breakers out of here too while you're doing this, so you can do it down here safely when you do the wiring. So on my panel, if I end up mounting this down here, I actually have to remove or relocate the ground bus right here. If I do it off to the side here, I actually have more room because I can mount it right there. I have enough service wires to kind of switch some of these back and forth, so I might do that. I could swap the 50 and the 40 right here because the wires are long enough. So to pull this out, you basically just have to pull that out. Now this thing is not connected to the bus anymore, so you're good on that. And then you could relocate these wires around here and then get it to the other side. Just gotta be careful not to touch anything. Get that over around this way, kind of bend it up and around, and then you can get off to this side. And then you could pop out this guy, do the same, move it onto the other side. And same with my pool pump, since I have room, I could actually pull this guy out, relocate it higher, pop that in. And then the low voltage or the 20 amp circuit, I could pop those out. Relocate those up higher. Also, the easiest way is on these square D ones is pop the back in and then push the front in. My next one is to try to finagle this out. So go ahead and turn that off. Right here, under the lugs, switch it over through all this stuff and then get it onto the other side. So right now, these two breakers are not hot. Easy, just rock it back and forth. Pretty much knock that out. Nice coin there. So the next thing we want to do is get the adapters in, the 1-inch to 1/2-inch adapters. So you want to sandwich your new O-rings in between into here. So if you want to put a secondary O-ring, you will go ahead and put one onto here also to seal it between here and the metal. So I'll go grab an O-ring for that. So I've got that O-ring right here, the little black O-ring onto there. Put the new adapter here on this side with the O-ring in between. Just sandwich it there, fish it through, get this other O-ring on this back side along with the lock nut. Thank you.
All right, it's pretty tight there. So we'll go ahead and fish the wires up to make our termination. Make sure everything's on. So what I'm gonna do first, I'm gonna go ahead and ground the two wires for this thing into the block up here. So right now, you always wanna get the shortest distance to ground as you can. This is the shortest up here, so that's all we got. So we'll go ahead, the green is a little bit longer, so I'll use that as the top one, and then the bottom one I'll unscrew. So these are little square bits, so let me go get a bit driver with the square bits. So we'll undo the ground bus. Alright, so the next thing I want to do, I want to unscrew these and get the other taps onto here. So remember, these things aren't current carrying, so it doesn't matter that they're thinner. They tell you that in the instructions, so you just want to make sure it gets in there and it gets a nice crimp. Usually it's illegal to double tap, especially if you have current carrying conductors, but these aren't current carrying, so we're not worried about that. Like I said earlier, the correct way to do this is to actually have a dedicated 50 amp, which we don't have room for in here. I'm supposed to torque these down, but ugga-muggas. Go ahead and push everything through. Kind of make sure nothing gets in the way. Tuck these things behind these little guides right here, and then just kind of bend everything in the way. Make sure the thing is off. Go ahead and pop these back sides in first. All right, so now we got both of them in. Flip it on. Both green lights are on there, so we're protected now. Go ahead, double check. Make sure everything is nice and flush into here before we put the panel back in and nothing gets in the way or gets jammed. All right, now we got it back all together. I'm gonna go ahead and put the cable surge protector down at the bottom here into the cable box. So pretty much just find the two spots that we're gonna be going. So the input is right here and the output is on top. So you could basically turn it however you need to, either this way or this way. For me, I guess I can do one side over here, that's input, and then the output. So I'll just put it this way. Go ahead and screw it in and then cut our ground wire and then just ground it through this bus right here. That's also chassis grounded to the ground, the main ground of the building here. Over, we'll go ahead, get a wire stripper, strip this down, ground it right here. All right, go ahead and cut that, strip the wire back, and then ground it with that guy right there. All right, pretty much done there. Just wire manage everything back. Put the cover back on and we're good to go here. Thanks for joining me on this quick video on getting this surge protector installed in here. As you can see, it's a pretty simple DIY project if you guys are comfortable around electricity and kind of just doing the wiring and all this mechanical stuff to get it installed. I'm looking forward to this actually protecting my house now during the lightning season. I won't lose any more electronics, motors, or anything else in the house. If you guys found this video useful for your own project, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel to stay on top of all my different DIY videos, go ahead and subscribe to your channel. Turn on bell notifications to get notified every time I upload. Remember guys, for all these different DIY projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.